Launching a startup is a long journey with many difficulties. But it gets easier with a friend. My CTO friend.
Hi everyone, and welcome to the CTO Tips. As a startup founder, you might consider to get maybe a cloud hosting or a server-based hosting for your web server or for your platform. But what is the real difference between both of them? Let me explain that, as usual, with a small drawing. If you are about to go for a server-based hosting, that means that you're going to bring a server, no matter where you go, you get that server. And on this server, you will have the website, you will have the data of your database, I mean, you will have media files here, and in fact you will have almost everything, maybe a mail server on the same server, which also means that if tomorrow you go on the TV and you have a very high traffic that try to connect to your website gonna crash. And that's usually the big drawback of using a classical web, a server-based hosting. Now let's talk about what is a cloud hosting. A cloud hosting is quite the same principle, but everything is separate, which means that you have a website. Okay, you're gonna put it on a big data warehouse where tens of computer servers are gonna wait for your website. So if at any time there is a high traffic, that's totally fine, because you will have here something that's going to redirect all the requests to as much server as required. Now let's talk about the database. If you are on a cloud-based database, usually you will be able to define what are the server size that you want to use for your database and move from one to another very easily and have some synchronization already up and running, which means that it's very easy for you to manage, very easy for you to scale, and very easy to restore at a point in time, which is something quite complicated when you only have your own server. It means that if you have a crash or maybe someone who do something wrong on your database, you can restore your database at any point in time, maybe 1 hour ago, 2 hours ago, 2 days ago, whatever. So that's very interesting and important. That's in the cloud configuration. Now let's talk about the mail. Of course, for the mail, it's going to be exactly the same as for the web website. You will be able to deploy your mail service on your hosting infrastructure. And for the media file, that's again same thing. You can replicate all your media file not only on several computers but all over the world, so that when you have some file that need to be downloaded, they are downloaded from the closest place from your visitor, and it's faster. It's regarding the performance, it's a lot better. So in that case, the infrastructure that are well known are S3 from AWS, Amazon Web Services, but that's not the only one. I also recommend to use and to check out Google Cloud Platform. IBM provide also great services, and there are Microsoft with Azure that provide also good cloud services. So I hope that explanation between a simple server service that might run out of power if you have a very high traffic, or an infrastructure based on cloud That the main difference is here we separate everything to be sure that everything is reliable enough for your growth. And that's why it's relevant for you to move on AWS, Amazon, Google, IBM, and so on and so forth if you want to grow your startup. Thanks for listening this short CTO tips. As usual, I'm looking to see you inside myctofriend.co. Bye for now.